Bienvenue for me, Em’kal Eyongakpa, a medium and a community organizer. My hometown, I was born by the River Manyu, like 2 kilometers from the river. And I've not been there for a while because of what's happening there. People are now refugees in Nigeria, so official numbers from the United Nations High Commission for Refugees is about 15,000. This is part of what officially they call Em’kal Eyongakpa Intermediate Studios.
Black people in music and literature have established. But the problem here now is we're learning who owns the intellectual property of black imagination.
For the performance, I added like voices from famous political prisoners like Mumia Abu-Jamal and Asata Shaku and some others. So it was this whole idea of doing a piece for healing and remembrance. Patrick Ndango, he made this video from a high security bunker, and we all just saw this following the crackdown of protesters in the English-speaking part of Cameroon. So when this video came out from this bunker without any access to light, the first thing that came to my mind was the sound. How the degree of torture they could go through, not just from that isolation, but from a sonic perspective. Water drops become torture at some point, because the healing aspects of water is very important for me, but at some point I wanted it to get to a point where it becomes torture, and also where, since my work has to do a lot with transformation and repetition, I wanted this water drops to be amplified through the acoustics, so it becomes like mantra's heartbeat. I could see my work as a negotiation between life sciences, juju art, and technology.